Around the world, there are species that only live in certain countries, states, and regions. These animals typically stay close to an area due to a specific habitat or food source. Traditionally, one such species has been the limpkin, a heron-like bird that in the US could only reliably be found in certain parts of Florida. Now, however, it seems the range of this fascinating species is expanding. So much so that even people in the Midwest may soon have the chance to see them without ever leaving their home state. While species ranges can expand and contract on a somewhat regular basis, the reason for the limpkin's sudden movement may surprise you. While limpkins may look like typical wading birds, they are actually quite unique. They are more closely related to rails than herons, even though they share a similar body shape to them. Limpkins are brown overall and have white speckling on their backs, sides, and head. They have more speckles on their neck and head, making it look paler than the rest of their body. One of the most interesting aspects of limpkin physiology is their curved bill, which is used to eat their preferred food source, apple snails. In fact, the expansion of apple snails is the primary reason that this species is expanding their range. The problem for the limpkin, along with other species such as the snail kite that feed mostly on apple snails, was that the native Florida apple snail could only survive in areas with specific conditions. The relationship between the snails and the birds meant that if apple snail populations declined, a decrease in limpkin abundance was sure to follow. This was the case throughout much of the late 1900s as limpkin populations in the United States dropped. But just as outlook for the limpkin in the United States was starting to look dark, an unexpected change occurred. In the mid-2000s, multiple types of invasive apple snails came to the United States, including the island apple snail and the channeled apple snail. These snails most likely arrived in the US from the pet industry when some were released. They quickly spread to many states and don't show any signs of slowing down. While these invasive snails pose a major threat to many native species and are considered an ecological problem by both conservationists and aquatic farmers, they're simply a buffet for limpkin. In the past 15 years, limpkins have left the confines of Florida and turned up in many different states, including Louisiana and Texas. Many people have noticed the limpkin appearing in areas where invasive apple snail populations are booming, and hope that the birds can actually help control the snail population and take pressure off of native wildlife. More studies will need to be done on how impactful limpkin can be for pest control, but for the time being, they are a welcome sight to both conservationists and farmers alike. The trend thus far is that if apple snails are around, the limpkin will follow. This has opened the door for many other states to have visiting and potentially even breeding limpkins make themselves at home for the summer or even longer. Limpkin may also show up in places without an abundance of apple snails, as they will also feed on other types of freshwater snails, freshwater mussels, seeds, insects, small vertebrates, and invertebrates. Among the more surprising states who have already recorded limpkin sightings are Kansas, Nebraska, Oklahoma, and Indiana, among many others. The only question now is, where will they show up next? In the coming years, it's quite possible that the range of the limpkin and limpkin populations could change dramatically. As this happens, birders will continue to look on in anticipation for these birds to show up in their home state. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time on Badgerland Birding.